Hello, everybody. It is I, Granorite, and here we are back with another episode of Let's Play Pokémon Crystal with our Gen 2 type challenge of Flying type. We are here in the post-game now, and if you haven't seen the post-game episode, we speed through this, except for the Gym Leader fights, because everything's super under level. I do have a new controller that I'm trying out, so hopefully it works out well. It's probably going to take me a little bit of getting used to, so anywho's. Pushing here. Well, that's probably easy here. Where is the normally, if I click off something, I can keep going. Doesn't seem to be doing that though. We'll just deal until I figure it out. Alright, who are we wanting to use against? I think we're wanting to use Ho-Oh. Vincent didn't serve. I'm sorry, I got a little itch in my mouth. As I'm talking, my sinuses and pollen and all that jazz. So yeah, I think we're going to use Ho-Oh against Lieutenant Surge, since Ho-Oh knows Earthquake. Still waiting for Moltres to learn flamethrower. That is the target move. That takes care of everybody on here, and Ho-Oh is ready to go. Get this girl back to her grandpa. But I am looking at finishing this playthrough today. I do have a meeting later that'll take place while I'm like leveling, so we'll do all the gems, I'll level off screen, and then we should be back to finish the playthrough afterwards. That is the plan at least. Not even fully evolved Pokemon in this gym. That's what it is. Alright, but it's time for our first gym leader. Probably the hardest one to face. Lieutenant Surge. Although Brock may be a little difficult. This team isn't, like, super good against rock types, but I think we'll still be okay. One down, four to go. We didn't miss one, but we got the second one, so that's good. Always seems to be a case of double team with earthquakes in this fight. This is the first one, get the second one. Amount of damage here with a fly attack. Alright. Which reminds me, I want to take this item off Aerodactyl. Or give this to Dodrio. Because I would rather have Aerodactyl have, in leftovers rather than the King's Rock, because it's going to benefit Aerodactyl more than it's going to benefit Dodrio. Psychic while we're here, might as well. Alright, in the Saffron's gem. Slowbro is going to take a few hits, but Moltres can take it. And they're going to swap with Aerodactyl. Alright. Let's go on with an Ancient Power. Maybe we'll get a stat boost. We did not. Instead, our accuracy got dropped. But we hit the wing attack. So that's good. At least the mine is gonna get this. We'll swap the Moltres since we got the stat drop. Good damage on that critical hit wing attack. We are faster than the Alakazam, so that's good. Good damage on that headbutt. We did not get a flinch though. Kind of fishing for that flinch. So as long as we didn't speed tie it, we were set. give those leftovers to Aerodactyl. And let's finishing level up. Finish leveling up this Aerodactyl. Swap Moltres here. Still no flamethrower. I was really hoping for a flamethrower. Oh. We're gonna let Moltres take on your attack. Ember! One down, three to go. We'll just wing attack this jump block. Ember! Oh, stayed alive. Use the acid on this, okay. She hyper potions, we just burn it again. Roasted pitcher plant. Oh man, it took in the sunlight.
Oh, my camera's like way over here. Hi! What are you doing way over there?
Insect stuff. That'll level up Moltres. And now it learns Slayer Thrower. Would have been nice to have in that last fight. But later better than never.
Words are tough this morning.
Let's swap Dodrio. How lucky is that? I'm just gonna drill peck through every day. And our drill pecks have a chance to flinch. Alright, let's swap to. Even though Ho-Oh is the correct Pokemon to select out of this team to use against Jasmine, we're gonna use Aerodactyl. It's not like Aerodactyl's bad. But it's not Ho-Oh in stats. Swap up the Dactyl. Yeah, you have to talk to these. I don't know why I forget. That'd be like every single time I come in here. But I did forget for a split second. Alright. time for Janine, the hardest of the Kanto generals. Aerodactyl's gonna come up with a nice H of power to start things off. Send out a Weezy. Let's headbutt it. Good flinch. The other Weezing. We're looking for some stat boosts. Toxic. No. We'll be fine. If this Ariados and Venomoth can stand up to a weak attack from Aerodactyl, I deserve to take some toxic damage. But I don't think that's gonna happen. Sleep. Swap of Moltres. Now, from here on out, the immediate future, it doesn't matter who we use because we just have the trainer slot on thing. So moveset-wise, I think I was going to teach Toxic to Dodrio in place of Pursuit. Ah, yes. The Hyper Beam. I've been saving a Pokemon power-up just for that. So let's swap to Dodrio. Oh, maybe we weren't teaching a Toxic. We weren't teaching Steel Wing. That's what it was. Oh well. Swap Polo up for this hiker. This is the part of the game where things just take a little bit because there are so many trainers for us to face. But we want the experience, so there's less scratch training with you at the end of the game. I mean, even with as many trainers as we have to face before we get to... what, blue? I think we'll be lucky if we get our team up to level 65 across the board. Thank you. Charizard, yeah, we'll just keep Dodrio up then. Just keep knocking out all these trainers. Remember, for this line of trainers, whenever we get to Cerulean, that's about the halfway point with all of them, so we're getting close. We're knocking through him pretty fast though, so that's nice. This is Steel Wing. Let's teach it to the Pokemon with no wings. That's where it will be most powerful. Don't need a wing to use Steel Wing. We'll just keep pushing. I think we have plenty of Pokemon power. Tanky mutts. Taking more than one hit for us to take down. Can you believe it? So who do we want to use against Misty? I guess the better question is who do we want to use against Brock? Thinking we use like Dodrio against Misty. It'll be our best matchup. Not that we're ready yet to take on Misty. Still gotta get the power plant issue taken care of. That Raichu hit my Ho-Oh. Can you believe the audacity? And this is the part of the game that just takes forever. Of course, what's really going to take forever is Grass training the team with level 65. That's going to take forever. We'll be right back. Okay. We just gotta get Misty back at the gym, and then we can keep knocking down gyms. Up to level 52. Dodrio, actually. Oh, I'll stay right now. Start off with a try attack. Good damage. We will take a surf. Is coming out next. This one looks like a blizzard. I'm gonna swap the hello. Let's put up a sunny day. And there's the rain dance. Alright, we're gonna counter with another sunny day. Take a surf at half damage. Look at that piddly damage.
Take a fire in the sun.
Quagsire is coming out next. Alright, we're gonna swap back to Dodrio. Let's try attack. Might get a status effect. Nope, it just uses amnesia. We're gonna swap back to Ho here for Starmie, and our Sunlight is gonna fade, but we're just gonna drop a Shadow Ball in this water Pokemon's face because it is Psychic type. And down it goes. Badge get. Capture the Snorlax and get its leftovers. Leftovers are on Ho-Oh. Switch Ho-Oh up, and then I didn't. Yeah, like, we're just now hitting 52 with everybody, so maybe we'll get 53 on everybody before we get to blue. 55 was definitely a stretch. Good damage. This should do it for Brock. Boom. Alright, let's swap up Moltres. Oops. A little too fast there. A level 10 Eradicate? Come on. That's illegal. Rival fight, and he's just a joke now, too. Thank you. get the little Viridian forest that they've cut down. Go take on Cal. Well, I think we will be able to get our whole team up to level 53 by the time we face Blue. Because Aerodactyl's about to level up, and then, Polo will definitely level up fighting Boy. Actually, I might just level up on the Starly. Alright, time for Blaine. Just this Rapidash and then it's done. Which means all we have left is Blue. Let's go get him. Team's all at level 53. Oh, we're gonna have so much ass leveling to do. Alright. Ninja power. Aha, we got the stat boost. And then it whirlwinds us. Really? Alright then. Meet the bird. Gyarados coming out next. No, Rhydon's coming out next. Alright, we're gonna keep Polo out. We're gonna Earthquake it. That's gonna hurt. It hurt? I told you it was going to. Alright, well let's see how much we can do with a steel wing. What the bad? Front row. Okay, use Sandstorm like a unique. Oh, it's so fast! I was hoping that Dodrio was going to outspeed it. Does tank the psychic with 10 health to spare. Clutch. That's gonna hurt. I mean, what else are we supposed to do? Like, Dodrio would have been the other Pokemon I sent out, but it's only got so much health left. I figured the full restore was coming, that's why I didn't Hyper Beam. You can extreme speed my Moltres, that's fine. It'll take me a few wing attacks, but we'll get there. And then we're just gonna flamethrower this Exeggutor. It's a tough fight, honestly. It's a good fight. Got it. That's not what I wanted, I wanted this. Well, this is where we're going to end our episode for this morning. Like I said, I'm going to level up off screen, and then we will be back with more Pokemon later to finish out this playthrough. So, we'll see you then. Otherwise, we'll see you next time.